Former Labour MP David Miliband claimed Britain is not taking in enough refugees, according to a report published by the United Nations stipulating the number of refugees the Western world should take in. Speaking on LBC, Mr. Miliband, President and CEO of the International Rescue Committee, said that Prime Minister Theresa May is offering even less of a humanitarian solution than David Cameron's government. LBC's Iain asked the former Labour politician if Britain was accepting enough refugees in the country. Getty LBC David Miliband claims Theresa May is taking even less refugees in than Cameron promised. Mr. Miliband replied, no. The Cameron government said it would take 4,000 a year, which equates to more or less 6 per parliamentary constituency. He added, remember, the Cameron government also, and I'm not a lawyer from the Cameron government, said we'll take 3,000 unaccompanied children, and Theresa May's administration has thrown that aside. Britain is the country that, when America was turning away Jews in the 1930s, took 10,000 children in. We did a calculation. We looked at the UN figure, and the UN say that the Western world should take over 5 years about 8% of the world's refugee population. If you make that for Europe, that's 540,000, and if you'd then do a calculation over 5 years, it's 108,000 a year. Tuesday, July 11, 2017, displaced people from the minority Yazidi sect, fleeing violence from forces loyal to the Islamic State. He added, if you look at the UK, you're looking between 20,000 and 30,000 a year, rather than the 4,000 or 5,000 that the Cameron administration said. So I would be saying 6 per parliamentary constituency is not going to overwhelm you. If there is a fair sharing of the burden, Britain will be taking about 25 per parliamentary constituency. The accusation comes after it was revealed that German Chancellor Angela Merkel adopted a refugee policy that welcomed more than 1 million refugees into Germany to save EU neighbor Greece from the Eurozone crisis. Writing for German newspaper Faz, Bremen-based political scientist Philipp Manau said, the opening of the border was the almost inevitable protection of the Greece deal.